Advent prayer. Out of the attentive stillness we've been keeping, our response will flow. It may be vocal, involving speaking to God, reciting the liturgy, or praying the Psalms. Articulating truths out loud is an important part of Advent waiting, for grief and lament need to be expressed. We may find, when we voice the Psalms, for example, that we are taken beyond our pain, so we can praise God once more. Evelyn believed some vocal prayer should be part of the daily rhythm of prayer. It provides discipline and shape and leads us on to slower, quieter, deeper stages. When we're distracted, we may find set prayers invaluable. A second form of prayer, meditation, was described by Evelyn as thinking in God's presence in a way that involves our whole being, mind, feelings, will, imagination, and body. We might begin by reflecting on a spiritual text, a Bible passage, for example, and spend time brooding over this before God. We don't need to try and engineer some type of meditative experience. We can simply focus on God in adoration, surrendering ourselves anew. Evelyn recognised that meditation upon the Christian mysteries, chewing the cud of the Gospels, as it were, provides nourishment and is an inexhaustible basis for prayer. Evelyn says, prayer is nothing else but a devout intent directed towards God. Augustine's great saying, love and do what you like, becomes more completely true. The soul's real progress is towards the unspoilt, trustful, unsophisticated apprehension of the little child. Meditation not only feeds, but also disciplines the mind and soul, gradually training us to steady our attention upon spiritual things. It helps us conquer distractions and forms an essential prelude to that state of profound recollection where the soul dwells almost without effort on things of God. A prayer. O God, I'm only real insofar as I'm in you and you're in me. Gather me in your arms and lift me above my troublesome, repetitive thoughts, so I may enjoy the serenity of your presence. Let me breathe deeply the breath of eternity and rest in your love. Then when I return to the everyday, clothed in your peace, may I do and bear whatever pleases you, in Jesus' name. So we take a moment of quiet now, to sit and to be. And we pray together with confidence the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.